नमस्ते एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर प्रतिभा केएस, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी एट केली सोसाइटीज एस निजिंगप्पा कॉलेज राजाजी नगर बेंगलुरु. टुडे आई एम बिफोर यू टू एक्सप्लेन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑन कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द ब्लड सेल्स एंड देयर जॉब्स. अंडर दैट टुडे विल बी गोइंग थ्रू WBCs व्हिच इज पार्ट 3. कैन नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट WBCs. व्हाइट ब्लड कॉर्पस्कल्स आर व्हाइट ब्लड सेल्स. You can see in WBCs, granulocytes are agranulocytes. Granulocytes where in the cytoplasm of the blood or WBCs, granules can be seen. Whereas agranulocytes, you can see the absence of granules, that is cytoplasm without granules. In granular cytoplasm, you can see acidophils, basophils, and neutrophils. Let us understand what is this: acidophils, basophils, and neutrophils. Okay, these cells were called acidophils because these cells were stained acidic stain. Okay, by using acidic stain, those cells were stained and they have taken up the eosin, and eosinophils are examples of acidic stain. That's why those cells were called acidophils. Whereas these base cells, basophils, they have taken up the basic stain. That's why in the beginning they called those cells as basophils. And the third one is neutrophils. These cells taken up both acidic as well as basic. That's why they called neutrophils, or neutral stains were taken by the both were taken. That's why they're known as neutrophils. Whereas here cytoplasm without granules, whereas lymphocytes and monocytes. Lymphocytes here, two types of lymphocytes, B lymphocyte and T lymphocytes can be seen. B stands for bone marrow, which are produced, this kind B lymphocytes which are produced by the bone marrow, and T lymphocytes which are produced by the thymus. Here T stands for thymus. Another one, WBC, you can see that is the monocytes. So this is all about the granulocytes and the agranulocytes of WBCs. Okay, this is the electron micrograph picture representation of RBCs and WBCs. Now let us understand in detail about WBCs, or white blood cells, or white blood corpuscles, can also be known as leukocytes. Okay, these are mobile units of body's defense system. These WBCs seek and destroy foreign bodies. Let us now go through their functions. These WBCs destroy invading microorganisms. Okay, destroy abnormal cells, that is cancer cells. They are also involved in assist in injury repair or clean up cellular debris through phagocytosis process. WBCs can also be known as leukocytes. In WBCs, we cannot see the presence of any kind of pigment, so there won't be any pigment. Okay, whereas in RBCs we can see the pigment like heme. Okay, that's why that particular blood corpuscles are red. That's why those were called red blood corpuscles. Here WBC size, which vary from 8 to 20 microns, number 6,000 to 10,000 millions per mm cube can be seen. RBCs and WBC ratios will be 600:1. For every 600 RBCs, one WBCs will be there. It means only whenever there is an infection or any kind of allergies, that time these WBCs concentration will be very high. Shape of the WBC, that may be round or irregular shape, can be seen. Okay, whereas in WBCs, nucleus can be seen. The shape of the nucleus will vary from one WBCs to other WBCs. Okay, that may vary in different types of WBCs. That's why those are known as polymorphic nucleus leukocytes. Poly means many, morphic morphology, right? Nucleus leukocytes. Leukocytes means WBCs. Okay, site of production, that is red bone marrow, lymph nodes and spleen. Then process of formation of leukocytes known as leukopoiesis. Increase, these WBCs increase only during the infection or any kind of allergies. That time what happens? Total count of leukocytes will be very high. Okay, that time we can say leukocytosis. Decrease in this particular leukocytes known as leukopenia, right? Then here WBCs also play a very important role in diapedesis. Okay, whereas in diapedesis, WBCs will squeeze out of the capillaries to fight against the infection. Okay, whereas here passage of blood cells through the intact walls of the capillaries. Okay, and these cells were flexible, flexible membrane can squeeze out of the capillaries. Now let us go through in detail about white blood cells. White cells are leukocytes exist in variable numbers and types but make up a very small part of blood's volume. Normally, only about 1% in healthy people. Healthy people, WBCs will be 1%. It means whenever the body gets infected, these WBC, which acts as a defense mechanism, which fights against the infection, that time WBCs count will be very high. Okay, leukocytes are not limited to blood. They occur elsewhere in the bodies as well, most notably in the spleen, liver, and lymph glands. Most are produced in bone marrow from the same kind of stem cells that produce red blood cells, and others are produced in the thymus gland, which is at the base of the neck. So you can keep in your mind, leukocytes are not limited only to the blood stream. Okay, some white cells called lymphocytes are leukocytes, which comes as leukocytes, are the first responders for our immune system. Okay, they seek out, identify, and bind to alien protein on bacteria. Alien means foreign, okay, viruses and fungi, so that they can be removed. Other white cells called granulocytes and macrophages then arrive to surround and destroy the alien cells or foreign cells. Here you can see the white blood cells are leukocytes. Beautiful diagram. Here you can see the leukocytes play varied immune system roles in damage, repair, and defense against non-self cells, tissues, organisms, and their toxins. Okay, here you can see basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils, monocyte, and lymphocyte play a very important role in defense and immunity system. Whereas here you can see thrombocytes are platelets, which are small, normally inactive cells, which play roles in hemostasis, that is clotting or preventing blood loss. These platelets will be normally inactive state in the blood cells. Whenever in the blood, whenever any injury occurs, only that time these platelets get activated. Okay, WBCs are amoeboid, colorless corpuscles, and their number vary from 6,000 to 10,000 millions per cube. It contains nucleus and cell organelles. Based on the presence of granules and shape of the nucleus, they are classified into two groups. They are granulocytes and agranulocytes. Let us understand first one, granulocytes. These are having granules in the cytoplasm which take up different stain and possess regular shaped nucleus connected by fine threads. They are of three types, okay? Neutrophil, basophil, and eosinophil. Now let us go to the next one, agranulocytes. Here, granules are absent. The nucleus is large and single lobed. There are two types, that is monocyte and lymphocyte, which comes under agranulocyte. Here you can see the beautiful picture of agranulocytes and granulocytes. Okay, each WBC has specific role to perform in the immunity. Okay, they have the specific job to perform in the immunity. Here you can see this is the lymphocyte, where a circular shape of the nucleus, monocyte bean shape or kidney shape, whereas eosinophil two lobes can be seen, whereas basophils again two lobes, but that will be with the S shape. And you can see here neutrophils, which will be having very irregular one, and they'll be having 3 to 5 lobes can be seen over here. This is all about the granulocyte, agranulocytes pictorial representation. Here you can see the different percentage or concentration of the WBCs in the bloodstream. Agranular lymphocytes 20 to 25%, and these lymphocytes also responsible for T cell, B cell, and NK cells. NK stand for natural killer cells. Monocytes 3 to 8%, basophils 5 to 1%, okay, neutrophils 60 to 70%, eosinophils 2 to 4%. Here you can also see this may vary, that is 1 to 5%, 0.5, sorry, not this, not Y, 5 to 1%, 0.5, right, 0.5 to 1% of basophils can be seen. Granulocytes are white blood cells whose cytoplasm contains tiny granules. Okay, the cells are named according to the staining characteristics of the granules. These granulocytes can also be known as polymorphonuclear granulocytes. Okay, in the MCQ questions they may ask you, just keep this in your mind. Neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils. Here you can see the pictorial diagram of WBCs, RBCs, and platelets. Here you can see basophils. Okay, basophil with quite S shape, and you can see the granules. Large granules can be seen over here. Here also you can see the granules. This is the neutrophils, where you could see 1, 2, 3, 4 lobes can be seen, and this is the monocyte. Very clear bean shape or kidney shapes can be seen. Eosinophils, these 2 lobes can be seen, and this is the lymphocyte with the larger nucleus and rim of cytoplasm can be seen over here. Okay, here this is the platelet or thrombocyte responsible for clotting of the blood. Okay, here you can see the erythrocyte. I told you the ratio of the RBC and WBC, 600:1. For every 600 RBCs, you are going to find 1 WBC. Okay, now let us understand one by one all the different types of WBCs, like neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils. They constitute 60-70% of all leukocytes. You can take pen and paper, you can make a note, you can make a comparative statement, you can make 4 columns, and you can have a difference between, you can have a look the difference about this WBCs. Okay, most abundant of WBCs, because it is having 60-70% when compared to all WBCs, this concentration will be, percentage will be more in number. Neutrophils are actively phagocytic. Cytoplasm contains fine granules, right, which take up both acidic and basic stains and stain purple. This particular cell has taken up both acidic and basic stains. That's why these cells were called neutrophils. They showed that neutral condition. They have taken up the acidic also, basic also. So they called those cells as neutrophils. Nucleus has 3-5 lobes. Okay, size of the neutrophil usually 10-12 microns. It protects the body against the invasion of bacteria, and they kill bacteria by digesting them by enzyme hydrolysis through the phagocytosis. Okay, phagocytes that engulf bacteria and debris. Okay, and these neutrophils play a very important role in inflammatory responses. What do you mean by inflammatory responses? A localized physical condition in which part of the body become reddened, swollen, hot, and often painful, especially as a reaction to injury or infection. Okay, whenever injury or infection happens, wherever that particular region, okay, there we can see redness or swollen condition or hot or even pain can be observed. Okay, that is an inflammatory response. Whenever any inflammation occurs, that response can be seen. Let us understand step by step here. Okay, step one here, what happens whenever the injury occurs here? Here, histamine and prostaglandins will be released. Okay, for example, injury occurs here, immediately these chemicals, okay, histamines and prostaglandin, they are the, those are the chemical signals. It means those are local immune response. Those are the mediator of itching, which gives the information to the nerves or to the blood region or to the, which also act like a chemotactic factors, which attracts the other cells which are responsible for defensive mechanism, which also gives the signal to the nerves. Okay, which also act like a neurotransmitter. Okay, injury has happened here, pathogen has entered inside, chemical signals will mediate the other immune cells. Okay, here you can see the leukocytes in the capillaries can be seen. Step two, capillaries dilate, clotting begins. Once the capillaries dilate, clotting begins due to the presence of platelets or fibrogen clotting factors. Step three, chemotactic factors attract phagocytic cell. Chemotactic factors means what are the histamines, the product prostaglandins were there, they attract the WBC cells, and there you can see the diapedesis. These WBCs will squeeze out of the blood capillaries and fight against the infection, okay, and brings the phagocytosis process. Okay, once the phagocytes happens, these phagocytosis which will digest the or which will degrade or which will kill the foreign invaders. Phagocytes consume pathogens and cell debris. So this is all about the inflammatory response which is carried out by neutrophils. Let us understand in detail here about mechanism of phagocytosis. Okay, here ingestion of bacteria or other materials by phagocytes. Step one, microbe adheres to phagocyte. Here microbe has entered here to that phagocyte that is going to adhere. Once that is adhered, next what happens? Phagocyte forms pseudopods, right? Phagocyte forms pseudopods that eventually engulf the particle or foreign bodies or alien particles. Then phagocytic vessel containing antigen is known as phagosome. This phagosome come in contact with the lysosome which are present in the phagocyte, okay, and forms phagolysosome. Okay, phagocytic vesicle is fused with the lysosome forming phagolysosome, and this lysosome which carry acid hydrolase enzymes responsible for killing the foreign bacteria. Okay, microbe infused vesicle is killed and digested by lysosomal enzymes within the phagolysosome, leaving a residual body. Okay, you can see here the residual body. Okay, then what happens? The fifth step, indigestible and residual material is removed by exocytosis method. Okay, now let us understand about eosinophils. Eosinophils, the shape of the nucleus will be two lobes can be seen, constitute 2 to 4% or 1 to 4% of the WBCs. In your examination, you write any one particular number or range. Okay, cytoplasm contains membrane bound granules, that is very large granules can be seen, which absorb acid dyes like eosinophil and stain red in color. Okay, nucleus is bilobed. Lobes are connected by an histones. Size of the eosinophils is 10 to 12 microns. They produce antihistamines that reduce or block histamines. So they stop allergy symptoms that destroy antigen antibody complexes also. These eosinophils causes tissues in nose to tissues of the nose is to swell, watery eyes, itchy rashes, skin called hives, then mouth itch can be seen. Whereas here hives, allergic reactions causing local redness or swelling or itching can be seen. Okay, these eosinophils will number will be increased when during the allergic reactions. Okay, during the attack of parasitic worms also eosinophils number will be very high, and this eosinophils are very important in allergic reactions. Whenever eosinophils concentration increased, one can understand that body got infected with some allergies. It means normal concentration will be 2 to 4% or 1 to 4% increase in eosinophil, which is one of the biological indicator, okay, to understand a person is infected by the allergies. It's also one of the diagnostic indicator. Now let us understand about the basophils. Basophils constitute 0 to 1% or 0.5% to 1% of the total WBCs. Okay, here cytoplasm contains large granules which absorb basic dye like methylene blue and stain blue in color. Nucleus is large and irregular lobed can be seen. The nucleus is quite S-shaped. Their number is increased during the pathological conditions like smallpox, chickenpox, etc. They migrate into tissues called mast cells and helps to facilitate inflammatory response, and they release histamine and heparin. Heparin, which play an important role in the anticoagulation, which prevents the coagulation of the blood, important in allergic reactions. Heparin also helps to clear fat from blood. Here you can see the beautiful picture of the WBCs. Here you can see basophils, S-shaped basophil, neutrophils, that is more than three lobes can be seen, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 to 5 lobes can be seen in the neutrophils, and where you can see very beautiful monocyte, kidney shaped or bean shaped nucleus can be seen. Okay, whereas this is the eosinophils with the two lobes. Here you can see the lymphocyte with larger nucleus, circular nucleus can be seen with the rim of, okay, with the thin rim of cytoplasm can be seen in the lymphocyte. Okay, here you can see the platelets or thrombocyte responsible for the clotting of the blood. Okay, whenever the cut happens, damage occurs, these platelets which will plug the cut region or damaged region and prevent the loss of the blood. Here you can see erythrocytes. Okay, erythrocytes do not play any role in defensive mechanism. Only WBC cells play a very important role in the defensive mechanism. Okay, now let us understand about egg granulocyte. As the name suggests, A means that is the absence of granules. Okay, egg granulocytes are white blood cells that have no distinct granules in their cytoplasm. Those are important part of body's immune system, like monocytes and lymphocytes. In monocytes, we don't have any kind of types, but in lymphocytes, we have two different types of lymphocytes, B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. B lymphocytes, which are produced by the bone marrow, and T lymphocytes, which are produced by the thymus. Now, let us understand about monocytes. These monocytes constitute 5% of the total white blood corpuscles. They are the largest cells of the blood and vital cells, which are very necessary to the body system. And here nucleus is kidney shaped or bean shaped. They act as scavengers, helping to remove dead and damaged tissues. They destroy the invading pathogens. The size of the monocyte is between 16 to 22 microns. They also play a very important role in phagocytosis process. So there's no phagocytic. They defend against viruses and bacteria, and they do not stay in blood. Instead, they migrate out of blood vessels and to cells and other tissues to become macrophages. And these macrophages are also known as big eaters. They eat all the foreign bodies and other different kind of alien substances. That's why they play a very important role in phagocytosis process. They phagocytize bacteria, dead tissue cells, and they also differentiate into later dendritic cells, that is antigen detecting cells. They exit blood through diaperesis, okay, process to become macrophages. They release numerous cytokines which act like a chemical messengers. Okay, now let us understand here about lymphocytes. They contain large nucleus surrounded by a thin film of cytoplasm. Basically, there are two types of lymphocytes, that is T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes. T lymphocytes produced in the thymus and B lymphocytes which are produced in the bone marrow. Lymphocytes are connected with immunity and produce antibodies. Okay, lymphocytes are responsible for production of the antibodies. Whenever the functional aspects come, that time we'll see and we'll say antibodies are AB. Whenever the structural representation comes, you need to use the terminology IG, that is immunoglobulins. Serum globulins help in wound healing and as a precursor of plasma cell. Based on the size, there are two different types of lymphocytes, large lymphocytes and small lymphocytes. Large lymphocytes are of 12 to 15 micrometer in size. Also, they become NK cells. Small lymphocytes, which are of 10 to 12 micrometer in size, divided into B and T lymphocytes. B, that is bone marrow. Plasma cells like immunoglobulins, memory, and T lymphocytes are T helper cells. You can also see T cytotoxic cells, T suppressor cells, which regulates the immune responses. Okay, with the association of T helper. 25 to 30% of the WBCs are B lymphocytes responsible for production of the antibodies. Okay, and production of antibodies, the process can also be known as humoral antibody mediated immunity. Okay, they fight against the antigen through the production of antibodies through humoral mediated immunity. Then T lymphocytes, whereas T lymphocytes are directly destroy virus, okay, invaded cells and cancer cell through cell mediated immunity. Okay, cell mediated immune response can be seen that does not involve in production of any antibodies. They exhibit activation of phagocytes or antigen specific cytotoxic T lymphocytes and release of various cytokines in response to an antigen injury or infections can be seen. So you should keep in your mind, in lymphocyte there are two types of immunity are going, two types of immune responses can be seen. One is B lymphocytes responsible for the production of antibodies with the process humoral mediated immunity, and T lymphocytes responsible for immune response, that is cell mediated immunity. You are going to understand this antibody mediated immunity and cell mediated immunity in types of immunity. Okay, hope you have understood, right? For defense against pathogens, we can say immune cells. Key points to remember: phagocytes. These phagocytes engulf and destroy pathogens like bacteria or viruses. Lobed shaped nucleus can be seen in the WBCs and granular cytoplasm. Okay, second point you need to keep in your mind: lymphocytes produces antibodies which bind to pathogens. Okay, rounded shape with large round nucleus can be seen. Non-granular cytoplasm can be seen in the lymphocytes. Other important jobs of the white blood cells: they produce antibodies which can recognize and fight bacteria. They produce antitoxins which neutralize the toxins, that is poisons that bacteria produce, which make us feel ill. So antibodies are going to fight against those antigens. Okay, dear students, you can take screenshot or you can pause the video and you can make a note of all these points. Okay, now let us understand about platelets or thrombocytes. Okay, here you can see platelets. Okay, cell fragments without nuclei bound to megakaryocytes, whereas WBCs you can see the nucleus. Here cell fragments without nuclei which are bound to megakaryocytes. Here platelets are blood bud off and are released into the blood. Okay, fragments of cytoplasm derived from megakaryocytes of bone marrow and then enter the circulation are responsible for the coagulation cascade. Color, these platelets are colorless minute fragments, non-nucleated disc, biconvex, discoid, irregular shape, size may vary from 2 to 3 microns. Their number is about 2 to 3 lakhs per mm cube. They help in clotting of blood as they contain thrombopectin and thrombokinase. Platelets are thrombocytes. They work with blood clotting chemicals at the site of wounds. They do this by adhering to the walls of blood vessels, thereby plugging the rupture in the vascular wall with fibrin threads, acts as molecular glue. You can also say this platelet, which is going to act like a molecular glue, which plug that particular damaged or cut region. They also can release coagulating chemicals which cause clots to form in the blood that can plug up narrowed blood vessels and prevent the loss of blood. Now let us understand the functions of platelets. Stop bleeding from a damaged vessel. The major function: stop bleeding from a damaged vessel, right? Hemostasis. The stopping of flow of blood is known as hemostasis. Three steps involved in hemostasis, that is vascular spasm, formation of a platelet plaque, blood coagulation or clotting. Okay, damage to blood vessel leads to vascular spasm, that is immediate constriction of blood vessel. Vessel walls pressed together become sticky or adherent to each other, minimize blood loss. And also we can see formation of platelet plug in the presence of fibrinogen or platelets. Then brings the blood coagulation or clotting can be seen over there. And these fibrinogen or platelets or thrombogen, always that will be inactive state. Okay. So once prothrombin get activated, that time this fibrinogen will get activated. Prothrombin or thrombin, soluble blood protein fibrinogen, which will become into insoluble fibrin. Okay. Fibrin exists as solid fibers which form a tight mesh over the wound or during the cut or anywhere damage which has occurred. Okay. The mesh traps platelets, leads to blood clot. Prothrombin and fibrinogen always present in our blood, but they are not activated until prothrombin activator is made when we are injured. Okay. Blood clotting occurs in a multiple step process. Okay. I'm not going to explain in detail about all that, how that plugging will be happening. Just you can keep in your mind, through coagulation cascade, these platelets are fibrinogen or thrombin, which is going to bring the clot of that particular damaged region and prevent the loss of blood. What do platelets do? Platelets are fragments of cells. Okay, you can see in my I hope you have seen that particular platelets diagrammatic of that cells, right? These are the like a clots, okay, fragments of cells. So platelets are fragment of cells which are enucleated. The job of platelets is to help blood clot and form a scab. Okay, platelets stick together like glue at the cut or wherever the damage has happened, forming a clot. This clot, what happens, which prevents the loss of blood, right? As the clot starts to get hard and dries out, a scab forms. Scabs are usually rough, dry protective crust and dark red brown, right? Their job is to protect the cut by keeping germs and other stuff out and giving the skin cells underneath a chance to heal by protecting from any kind of foreign invaders. The platelets are involved in the formation of fibrin, right, which is needed for clotting blood. It means these clotting factors are always in the inactive state, and only when through this prothrombin activation, right, that time the blood clotting factors will get activated and form a scab. This is useful for stopping bleeding and for preventing germ from entering the body through the cut. One is to prevent the loss of the blood. Other one, this particular platelets also play a very important role in protecting or preventing the germs from entering the body through the cuts, any kind of damaged portion. Okay, here you can see the different concentration of WBCs. Okay, neutrophil 60 to 70%, lymphocytes 20 to 25%, monocyte 3 to 8%, eosinophils 1 to 3%, basophils 1%. Okay, to keep this in your mind, you can also keep this particular sentence: never let monkeys eat bananas. Okay, it means here N for neutrophils, okay, L for lymphocytes, and M for monkeys, E for eat, okay, that is eosinophils, B for banana, that is basophils. Okay, you can keep this in your mind about WBCs. Never let monkeys eat bananas. Here you can see the blood components in a centrifuge tube. Okay, after the centrifugation of the blood, okay, you can see here this the serum, right, liquid part of the blood, plasma, right? Once all the cells, all the blood cells, okay, formed elements were removed, this is how it looks. Straw colored and liquid part of the blood, which is a 55%, and 45% red blood cells are erythrocytes, and in the center you can see buffy coat, which is less than 1%. You can see white blood cells or platelets can be seen. Here I have given tabular representation or summary of all the different cells, okay, erythrocytes and WBCs and also platelets. See, first column I have given here cell type, second column occurrence in blood per mm³, cell anatomy and functions. You can take a screenshot, okay, or you can pause video, we can make a note of all this information of about erythrocytes, leukocytes, neutrophils, eosinophils. Okay. In the next slide, you can see here basophils, then lymphocyte, monocyte, and platelets. Its respective occurrence in blood, cell anatomy, and function. You can take a screenshot or pause video. Kindly make a note of this one. Let us now go through here summary of the composition of blood. Okay, when you take a blood, you can see the components like plasma, red blood cells, red blood corpuscles or white blood corpuscles, and platelets. Plasma, which is 55% to 60%, okay, whereas red blood corpuscles 40% to 45%, white blood corpuscles and platelets less than 1% can be seen. Okay, plasma, which is the fluid portion of blood, which contains 91% to 92% of water, albumin and globulin, crucial hormones and clotting factors can be seen. Okay, red blood corpuscles responsible for the exchange of respiratory gases. Okay, exchange of respiratory gases and protection. Right? Exchange of respiratory gases can be seen in the red blood corpuscles. Right? And also regulation. Right? Whereas in the white blood corpuscles are main role in defense mechanism, which protect against diseases and infections. Okay, here the platelets, which play a very important role in preventing the loss of blood and also protect from the any kind of invading germs, okay, during the cut or damage by forming the cascade or platelet plug. Small plate shaped cells that cluster together to help form blood clots when bleeding occurs. Okay, this is about the summary of the composition of blood. Here you can see the entire summarized view of blood cells, percentage, okay, size, nucleus, cytoplasm, granules, lifespan, formation, and the respective functions, and the diagrammatic representation. Here I've given the percentage. Okay, here this is neutrophils 60% to 70%, basophils less than 1%, acidophils 1% to 3%, monocytes 3% to 8%, and lymphocytes 30%. Okay, this percentage you can keep in your mind. Some of the books slight variations can be seen, but you can write this one. Okay, I hope you have understood today's concept. Hope to see you again in my another video. Okay, if you would like to share, subscribe, you can do it right now. I, Dr. Pratibha K, signing off for today. Stay tuned with me. Stay blessed. Keep learning. Protect yourself and protect others. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka. Thank you for watching.